Now we are going to do a wave weave. And when you do that, mark your beginning spoke again. And then you're going to have two weaving elements. I have a number two round and 11/64 flat oval in two different colors. So this is going to be a continuous weave. So with the flat oval, you're going to need to taper. And by doing that, you need to face it towards you, the oval side up, and then you're going to start a point and go 4, 5, 6 inches. Make it a nice smooth transition and taper off to the right if you're a right-handed weaver. If you were left-handed, you would taper to the left. So now it thins out. And this is the element you're going to start weaving with. So I'm going to place it behind the marked spoke. You're going to weave over, under, over, under two times, and then stop. Now you're going to pick up your round reed and just consider the spoke one, spoke two. You're going to lift up your flat oval so that you can just lay this round reed underneath it and then pack it down behind the spoke two. Now you're going to weave with the round reed over under, and then when you get here, you're going to pick your flat oval up, hold it out of the way, and go underneath the weaver and the spoke both. So this is the pattern that's going to repeat around your basket. The flat oval is just going to go over under, nothing else. Two times, over, under, over, under, then stop. Pick up the round, over, under, and then you go under and under. Under the weaver and under the spoke. And then you pick up your flat oval again. Over, under, two times. Round reed, over, under, and then under the weaver, under the spoke. And then pack it down. When you come back around to where you started, this is continuous, so you're just going to keep going. There's no step up, nothing changes. And it'll take about 3 or 4 rows before you start seeing the pattern. So I'll come back around and show you when we come back to the spoke. Okay, now we're getting close to the beginning where we started. So when you get here, you just keep doing your regular pattern, and it'll go right on top of what you've already done. And then we're just going to keep going. 1, 2, over, under, under, under. Go down the row. After several rows, you're going to see the wave. You're going to start seeing a line that will go at a diagonal form. And I'll do a couple rows, and then you'll be able to see it much better. Okay, so I've gotten several rows done. So you should be able to start seeing the design. The diagonal weave will be going at an angle to the left. And then the other weaver, the other blue line, will be little steps in between. If you have this line going and then all of a sudden it's not there, if it's jumped or it's going in a different direction, that means you have a mistake. You need to go pull back until you find it and go again. So you should start seeing this line there all the way around your basket. Now we're going to be ready to add in a new weaver. So when you get close to the end. So for the round weave, we're going to add this in first and just finish the pattern. Stick behind, trim it off. Grab your new end and stick it right behind same spoke. Hold on and then weave on with your, and that'll help hold it in. Now to add in with the flat oval, you don't want to add in the very same spot, so make sure you're down a few inches. So, I'm going to shave off some of the top since it's flat oval, so it won't be so thick. And then when you get there, you might have to do a little adjustment. Bring that in just a little bit more. So it's just laying on top of your spoke. Now I'm going to shave the underneath side of my new weaver. When they overlap, there won't be so much bulk. And I'm going to go back so they're overlapping four spokes. Now we're back in business. Over under, over under. Okay. Now I'm going to do one more row and then I'll show you how to end. Now we're at the end where we need to finish off. Here's my marked spoke where I began on the first row. So we are going to taper again to end. So I look at how far the taper at the bottom is, and I want to taper my flat oval the same amount. So about that far. So I'll measure. Send that off, and then I'm going to taper this time. Start your point, and you're going to veer off to the left. That way the cut side will be facing down and won't show as much, so that the white line when you cut won't be facing up. You want it facing down. And then I'm going to basically weave until I run out of the gray. So now I can take that out of the way. Behind there, and just ending behind.